When one finds a worthy wife, her value is far beyond pearls. Her husband, entrusting his heart to her, has an unfailing prize. She brings him good and not evil all the days of her life. She obtains wool and flax and works with loving hands. She puts her hands to the distaff and her fingers ply the spindle. She reaches out her hands to the poor and extends her arms to the needy. Charm is deceptive and beauty fleeting. The woman who fears the Lord is to be praised. Give her a reward for her labors, and let her works
Show us how to overcome the obstacles that we may encounter along the way.
That St. Stanislaus' desire to follow the plan of God in his life may inspire us to seek and follow God's will each day. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may learn from the example of our patron not to allow obstacles to prevent us or turn us away from the plans that God has for us. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our young parishioners may, like St. Stanislaus, consider a vocation to the priesthood or the religious life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the example of St. Stanislaus may give us strength to continue to hope, even when things do not turn out the way that we expected. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And that the will of God, which guided the entire life service of Stanislaus Kostka, may inspire church and political leaders to guide their people towards peace and justice for all. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all of our deceased relatives and friends may join St. Stanislaus in the joy of God's eternal kingdom. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, hear our prayers as we honor the life and the death of our patron saint. May his example give us courage to follow you even in the difficulties of a pandemic, so that we may one day join with him and you in the kingdom of heaven. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Next week, our second collection is for Catholic Charities Campaign for Charity and Justice. Practice families in the Archdiocese live in poverty. Last year, this collection helped parish-based efforts to help the poor in our New York area. By supporting this collection, you can make a real difference.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. Through your goodness we receive the bread and the wine of offering. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, let them become our spiritual food and drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Now let us pray that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his
sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night before he was to suffer, on the night of his last supper, he took bread and he said a blessing. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant. It will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, Holy Fathers, we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son and our Savior, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of his resurrection, and whom you have seated now at your right hand. We proclaim the work of your love until he comes again. We offer you bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor on the oblation of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us. Grant that by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the followers of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. By our partaking of this mystery, Almighty Father, give us life through your Spirit. Grant that we may be conformed to the image of your Son and confirm us in the bond of communion together with Francis, our Pope, Timothy, our Bishop, with all the bishops, priests, and deacons, and your entire people. And grant that all the faithful of the Church, looking into the signs of the times by the light of faith, may constantly devote themselves to the service of the Gospel. Keep us attentive to the needs of all, so that sharing their grief and pain, their joy and hope, we may faithfully bring them the good news of salvation and go forward with them along the way of your kingdom. Remember our brothers and sisters, especially May Miriam, who have fallen asleep in the peace of Christ, and all the dead whose faith in the Lord have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your presence, and in the resurrection give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, that when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place to live with you forever. There in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the Apostles, the Martyrs, St. Stanislaus Kostka, and all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son. Through him, with him, in him. O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. And now at the Savior's command, formed by divine teaching, we have the courage to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, so that by the help of your mercy, we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom, the power, and the glory of your Lord is now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "I leave you peace, my peace I give you." Lord, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church. Graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let's share with each other some gestures. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. This is the